Morning students, how are you? Today we are going to learn about some parts of India. That means we are going to learn about northern India, northern parts of India. There are mountains in the north, plains in the north, lying. These topics we will learn in this chapter. Which are the mountains in the north? We know there is a big mountain in the north side of the area. And plains in the north. If there is mountain near the plains, one is and life in the north. The lifestyle of people who live in. First of all, mountains. Most of the hill stations in the north of India are situated in Himalayan range, which is the highest mountain range in the world. We already learned that highest mountain range in the world, Himalaya, is in the north of India. There are many hill stations in this mountain. The Himalayas start from Jammu and Kashmir and passes through Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Manipur, Nagaland, Tripura, Mizoram, Meghalaya, and Assam before ending in the northeastern state of Arunachal Pradesh. There are many states included. Himalaya attached with these all states, which are the Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Manipur, Nagaland, Tripura, Mizoram, Meghalaya, and Assam, before ending the northeastern state of Arunachal Pradesh. The last, the northeastern state is Arunachal Pradesh, and they start from Jammu and Kashmir. It has an approximate length of 2,500 kilometers. The length of the Himalayan range in India, there are 2,500 kilometers approximately, not exactly. Lagbhag 2,500 kilometers ka lambai hai and its breadth varies from 150 kilometers to 400 kilometers. And its breadth, the chaudai, lambai 2500 kilometers and chaudai 150 kilometers to 400 kilometers. Sare jagah mein ek jaisa nahi, kuch jagah mein चौड़ाई कम है 150 किलोमीटर एंड कुछ जगह में चौड़ाई 400 किलोमीटर 400 किलोमीटर तक है. इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ हिमालय रेंज. इट इज लाइक ए बाउंड्री वॉल ऑन द नॉर्दर्न बॉर्डर्स ऑफ अवर कंट्री. इन अवर हाउस देयर इज ए बाउंड्री वॉल. इन अवर लैंड देयर इज ए बाउंड्री वॉल. बाउंड्री वॉल मीन्स जो अपना घर के चारों तरफ हम वॉल बनाते हैं, उसी तरह अपना कंट्री में नॉर्थर्न बॉर्डर में नॉर्थ उत्तर सीमा में एक बाउंड्री वॉल जैसे हिमालय खड़े होते हैं. इट प्रोटेक्ट अस फ्रॉम द कोल्ड ड्राइविंग्स that blow from Central Asia and also blow the monsoon winds from crossing the northern borders, resulting in very heavy rainfall in the northern plains. It protects us from cold dry winds that blow from Central Asia. Himalaya हमारे देश के लिए बहुत बड़ा कार्य करता है. ये वो नॉर्थ से सेंट्रल एशिया से जो ठंडी ठंडी बहुत तो ठंडी हवा आते हैं उसको रोक देते हैं। और हिमालय ये ऐसे उस जगह में खड़े होते हैं इसलिए ठंडी हवा हमारे देश में नहीं आती है, इसलिए बहुत बड़ा ठंड से हमको बचाते हैं। एंड ऑल्सो ब्लॉक्स द मानसून विंड्स फ्रॉम क्रॉसिंग द नॉर्थन बॉर्डर्स रिजल्टिंग इन हेवी रेनफॉल इन द नॉर्थन प्लेन्स। जो समुद्र से मानसून विंड आते हैं उसको हिमालय वहां रोक देते हैं, इसलिए पार करके नहीं जाते हैं सेंट्रल एशिया की तरफ और अपना नॉर्थन प्लेन्स में बहुत सारा बारिश हो जाते हैं, इसलिए अच्छा बारिश वो पानी वहां मिलते हैं। वी गेट बर्सेस वोट एंड अदर यूजफुल प्रोडक्ट्स फ्रॉम द फॉरेस्ट इन द हिमालय रीजन। हिमालय रीजन से हमको और मिलते हैं, मेडिसिन मिलते हैं, फॉरेस्ट से वुड मिलते हैं, लकड़ी मिलते हैं, अदर यूजफुल प्रोडक्ट्स फ्रॉम फॉरेस्ट। फॉरेस्ट से बहुत सारा चीजें हमको मिलते हैं। We get water for regular use and irrigation from the rivers originating in the Himalayas. हिमालय से जो नदी उद्भव होते हैं वो नदी में बहुत सारा पानी आते हैं, पानी का मुझे कमी ये भी हिमालय का एक प्लस पॉइंट है। We get electricity from the dams and across the rivers originating in the Himalayas. हिमालय से जो नदी आते हैं वो नदी में डैम बना के वो डैम में पानी को रोक के इरिगेशन के लिए हम यूज करते हैं, सिंचाई के लिए यूज करते हैं, खेत में पानी डालने के लिए, खेती करने के लिए भी हम यूज करते हैं। ये हमारा हिमालय का इम्पोर्टेंस पॉइंट। द हिमालय कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री माउंटेन रेंजेस alongside each. There are three ranges in Himalayas. The Greater Himalayas or the Himalayan range. First, Greater Himalayas is the dusre name Himalayan range. Ye sabse uncha hai. Second, the Middle Himalayas or the Himachal range. Dusra, sabse upar Great Himalayas iske बाद मिडिल हिमालयस वो थोड़ा ऊंचे हमें लास्ट थर्ड द आउटर हिमालयस और शिवालिक रेंज। ओ शुरुआत सबसे छोटा पहाड़ इसी एरिया में ऐसे थ्री पार्ट्स होता है, कहते हैं हिमालय ग्रेट हिमालयस और द हिमालय रेंज, द मिडिल हिमालयस और द हिमाचल रेंज, the outer Himalayas and the Shivalik range. Now we are going to learn about one by one. First, the Greater Himalayas and the Himalayan range. It is the highest range among the three ranges that remains covered with snow throughout the year. It is the highest range in the three range, which is what? Greater Himalayas or Himalayas. And throughout the year, it covered with the snow. Pura saal ye baraf se dhaka hua hai. Sabse uncha pahad hai. Kaun sa hai? Greater Himalayas or the Himalayas. Mount Everest, the highest peak in the world, with a height of 8,848 meters is in Himalaya, this Greater Himalayas. It is the highest peak in the world, which Mount Everest. Mount Everest is in the Greater Himalayas. The height of the Mount Everest is 8,848 meters. Meters. And the second highest mountain, Mount Godwin Austin. is also in this region, and it is the height 8611 meters. Mount Everest is 8848 meters, and the second highest Mount Godwin Austin 8611 meters. The second name is K2 or Mount Godwin Austin. That in the Sutlej, Ganga, Yamuna, and the Yamuna, there are many reviews also originating from the Himalaya range. Which are they? Indus, Sutlej, Ganga, Yamuna, and the Brahmaputra. These reviews are also originating from the Himalaya range or the greater. These rivers are formed due to the melting of glaciers. In this rivers, in the rainy season, by the rainwater, there will be flood. And in summer also, these rivers are flooded by the melting of glaciers. Glacier means slowly moving huge chunk of ice. What is glacier? Glacier is a slowly moving huge chunk of ice. बहुत बड़ा बर्फ का एक टुकड़ा. वो धीरे-धीरे चलते रहते हैं और वो पिघलते रहते हैं. जो बर्फ पिघलेगा तो धीरे-धीरे इसका मूवमेंट भी होता है. हिमाद्री रेंज में समर सीजन में ऐसा बर्फ पिघलते हैं और बहुत बड़ा बाढ़ आ जाते हैं. नदी में बहुत बड़ा ज्यादा पानी आ जाता है. सेकेंड वन the middle Himalayas or the Himachal Ridge, the middle part. From its name we can understand it is the middle part, middle Himalayas or Himachal Ridge. Himachal Ridge is located to the south of the Himachal Range and is lower than the land. The Himachal Range has many river valleys in their courses. Many hill stations such as Chimda, Kullu, Masuri and Darjeeling are located in this range. The slopes of mountains in this range are covered by thick forests of pine and juniper. The Middle Himalayas, there are many river valleys and passes. Many hill stations also, which are named Shimla, Kullu, Masuri, Darjeeling located in this range. A hill station. The hill stations means we can stay there in summer season. We will feel very good atmosphere and a pleasant climate. We can stay there very so people used to go there in decisions in summer season. The slopes of the mountains in this range are covered by thick forests. In this range, the slopes of the mountains are covered by thick forests. बहुत घने जंगल ये रेंज के ये माउंटेन के वहाँ बहुत ज्यादा पेड़ पौधे होते हैं, पौधा मिलते हैं और महंगा महंगा पेड़ भी मिलते हैं. ये सारे the middle Himalayas contain. Next, the outer Himalayas form the Pashchima Himalayas. Third range, the outer Himalayas form the Shivalik range. It is the southernmost and the lowest of the Himalayan mountains. Southernmost, south part of the सबसे लोस सबसे नीचे का हिस्सा है आउटर हिमालयस वहां से माउंटेन शुरुआत द स्लोप्स ऑफ दिस रेंज आर आल्सो कवर्ड बाय डेंस फॉग्स इसका स्लोप में भी इसका शुरुआत का भाग में भी बहुत घने जंगल होता है द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न पार्ट्स ऑफ द शिवालिक आर नोन एज द पूर्वांचल The northeastern part of the Shivalik. This range is known as another name that is Purvanchal Range. Shivalik range is known as Purvanchal Range. It is the another name of Shivalik. What is that? Purvanchal. Many small hills such as Garo, Khasi. India, Naga, Lushai, and Pisu are part of the Purvanchal Range. These are small hills, not like a Mount Everest or Mount Kilimanjaro, Costian, like that are the highest peak in the Himalayan range. In Shivalik range, there are small hills named Garo, Khasi, India, Naga, Lushai, and Pisu are the part of the Purvanchal Range. These are also in Shivalik Range. These three ranges are located side by side, and so it is very difficult to travel from one range to another. First, Greater Himalayas or Himadri. In the middle Himalayas or Himachal Range, and third, the outer Himalayas or Shivalik Range. In Himalayas, there are three ranges. Its breadth is 150 km to 400 km. You can think that 1 km is how much we, if we walk, we can use 10 minutes, proper walk, we can reach 1 kilometer. And 150 kilometer to 400 kilometer. And it is also very dense forest. There are many trees and animals and many other poisonous snakes, everything is there. Think how much difficult it is pass through the through from one side to another. Ek side se dusra side mein jaane ke liye kitna difficult hai, kathin hai. Aap socho 150 किलोमीटर से 400 किलोमीटर तक इसका चौड़ाई है उसमें पार करने के लिए आर पार करने के लिए कितना कठिनाई होते हैं खड़े जगह सो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू क्रॉस द हिमालय रेंजेस वन साइड टू अनदर सो देयर आर सम पासेस like Karakoram, Karakoram in Kashmir and Shipri Lam in Himachal Pradesh how we built to travel easily. One side to another. In mountain ranges, one side to another, we people used to cross the mountain some places. These places are known as passes. Like in Kashmir, there is a pass named Karakoram and Himachal Pradesh, Shiptila. These places are people usually to cross one place to one side to another. In this process, people can cross the Himalayan range, travel east. In 1984, Bajendripal created a record by becoming the first Indian man to climb Mount Everest. Already you know who was the first Indian woman climbing the Mount Everest. Who is Bajendripal in 1984? And after that, many people climbed the Mount Everest, and the first name is Bajendripal. Okay, and the second place in the north. The northern plains stretch between the states of Punjab, the northwest, and Assam, the northeast. This region is also known as the Indo-Gangetic Plains. Northern plains is known as Indo-Gangetic Plains. From Punjab in the northwest, and the Assam in the northeast. Punjab in the northwest, and the Assam in the northeast. It is known as Indo-Gangetic Plains. In this place, Indus River and the Ganga River is there. In both these plains come this region. The rivers Indus and Satluj, Ganga and Brahmaputra originate from the Himalayas and flow to the northern plains. Only we know which rivers are originating from Himalayas. Indus River and Satluj also. Ganga and Brahmaputra, these rivers are originating from Himalayas and flow through the northern plains. These rivers carry silt or alluvium which make the land fertile. What is silt? The flowing water by the river carry very soft to the water. So it is called a silt or alluvium, which make the land fertile. जो नदी के द्वारा बहते हुए आते हैं बिल्कुल मुलायम मिट्टी, वो मिट्टी बहते बहते नीचे आएंगे प्लेन में जम जाएंगे. ये मिट्टी में बहुत अच्छा उपजाऊ मिलते हैं. वो नदी के साइड में ये जम जाते हैं, उसमें उस साइड में खेती करेगा तो बहुत अच्छा फसल देते. ये रिवर पैसेज इज एन एरिया ऑफ लैंड ड्रेन बाय रिवर एंड इट्स ट्रिब्यूटरीज. रिवर पैसेज, रिवर पैसेज जो नदी के द्वारा बहते हुए मिट्टी और वो नदी के किनारे पे और जो बहते हुए जाते हैं उसके बीच में जम जाते हैं, जो साइड में जम जाते हैं. आज से बनाया हुआ जगह बहुत अच्छा होता है. द नॉर्थन प्लेन्स कैन बी डिवाइडेड इन द फॉलोइंग थ्री बेसिन्स. नॉर्थन प्लेन्स, नॉर्थन प्लेन इज नोन एज इंडो गैंगेटिक प्लेन्स. विच रिवर्स आर फ्लोइंग देयर? इंडस, सतलज, ब्रह्मपुत्र एंड are the rivers. Now we can see which basins are here. There are three basins. First, Indus basin. Second, Ganga basin. And the third, Brahmaputra basin. नदी के किनारे पे जो जगह पे है वहां लेट अस लर्न मोर अबाउट दिस रिवर बेसिन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इंडस बेसिन द इंडस बेसिन लाइज द स्टेट ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर हिमाचल प्रदेश पंजाब राजस्थान हरियाणा अंडर यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ चंडीगढ़ द रिवर सतलज बिलोंग टू द रिवर्स जला रवि व्यास चेनाब फ्लो इन दिस The Indus Basin, Indus River and the its tributaries. Tributaries, Jala. Tributary means the small river join the main. That is called a tributary. जो प्रमुख नदी होते हैं उसके साथ छोटा छोटा नदी बीच में जुड़ जाते हैं ये नदी को tributaries Which tributaries are joined with the Indus River, Satluj, Jhelum, Ravi, Bias, and Chenab. These all rivers make the Indus Basin. The Bakranagal multi-purpose dam that goes the Satluj River, supply electricity and water for irrigation to the state of Punjab. Bakranagal is the highest dam in our country and it is built in Satluj so the water of the Bakranagal dam used to electricity produce electricity and the water for irrigation the state of Punjab and Haryana next Ganga Basin The Ganga Basin is spread across the state of Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, and the West Bengal. The river Ganga originates from the Gangotri Glacier in the mountains. Ganga Basin, the main river is Ganga, and it's a tributary. And Ganga is originated from the Gangotri Glacier in the mountains. The river Saraswati and Yamuna join the Ganga. Ganga is the main river and Yamuna and Saraswati also join with the Ganga and where at Allahabad in Uttar Pradesh it is known as Triveni Sangam in Allahabad is a confluence of these three rivers Confluence means the meeting of three rivers. Which rivers are there? Ganga, Yamuna, and Saraswati. These three rivers meet together at Allahabad, Uttar Pradesh. This is known as Triveni Sangam. Next, Brahmaputra. The Brahmaputra Basin forms a narrow strip of area in the state of Assam. Brahmaputra Basin is a narrow strip. बिल्कुल चौड़ाई इसमें कम ऐसे बन जाते हैं. The Brahmaputra River originates in Tibet and is called the Sangpo. Brahmaputra River कहाँ से उजने करते हैं स्टार्ट होता है टिबर से और टिबर में ये ब्रह्मपुत्र नदी का नाम है सैंग इट एंडेस इंडिया टू अरुणाचल प्रदेश एंड देन फ्लो टू असम एंड एंडेस इन द बे ऑफ बंगाल और टिबर से उल्फा होता है इसके बाद वो अरुणाचल प्रदेश में इंडिया में प्रवेश करते हैं असम से बहते हुए बे ऑफ बंगाल में फिनिश करते हैं नेक्स्ट पीपल पीपल इन द नॉर्थ पीपल लिविंग इन द स्टेट ऑफ द नॉर्थन माउंटेन्स एंड द लेक्स स्पीक डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस एंड हैव ए वाइड वैरायटी ऑफ क्लोथिंग इन नॉर्थ इंडिया local friends, people are speaking in different languages. Alagalaga language bolte hain. And a wide variety of people, very different clothes they are wearing. Kashmiri, Ladakhi, and Dogri are the languages spoken in Jammu and Kashmir. Which are they? In Jammu and Kashmir, Kashmiri, Ladakhi, and Dogri. These are the languages. Whereas Hindi and Urdu are spoken in Uttar Pradesh. In Uttar Pradesh, Hindi and Urdu. Different languages are spoken in each of the northeastern states as well. Other states also, they have their own languages. Different languages are spoken in each of the northeastern states as well. For example, Assamese is the regional language of Assam and Manipuri in Manipuri. Traditional dresses of women in the northern region are salwar kameez, ghagra, mohri, and kachori and sari. Firak is an outfit that is a popular in Kashmir. Kashmir ka ek popular dress hai, famous dress hai firak. Wo bahut Kashmir mein bahut trend hota hai. Isliye wahan bahut lamba kapda wo pehante hain. Aur main usually pe kurtas, churas, shermanis aur firans aur salwars, chudidars embroidered caps or turbans are also worn by men in certain areas. Woolen shawls like the Pashmina shawl of Kashmir are famous all over the world. There is a kind of shawl, it is famous all over the world. Its name is Pashmina. It is made by the gods in the highest region of Kashmir. Kashmir ka bahut uncha pahad mein jo ek tarah ki goat rehte hain, wo goat ka wool se ye Pashmina shawl banate hain. Usme hamara ye bhaga 4-5 se fir hum paate hain. कितना गरम मिलते हैं उतना गरम मिलते हैं वो एक ही शॉल उतना अच्छा क्वालिटी है पश्मीना पीपल यूज दिस द शॉल इज ए प्रोमिनेंट क्लोथिंग आइटम फॉर मेन एंड वुमेन ऑफ नागालैंड नागालैंड में भी लोग शॉल पहनते हैं ईच ट्राइब ऑफ नागालैंड वेयर्स ए पैटर्न शॉल व्हिच इज the cloth of shawl is very different in Nagaland. We can identify the people by their shawl. It is the pattern, the design is different. Patterns of shawls are in identifying the types. Next vegetation. The northern mountains are covered by thick forests of pine and you also already see that. Most of the land in the northern plains is cultivated. Northern plains mein jyada se jyada jagah cultivate kar sakte hain, kheti kar sakte hain. Some major crops such as rice, jute, wheat, sugarcane and maize are grown. Next, wildlife. Wildlife sanctuaries and then parks. Wildlife sanctuaries are national parks are protected. Wildlife sanctuaries under national parks. These areas are protected by government. They are declared as nature reserves by the government of India for the preservation of wild animals and their natural surroundings. जो जंगली जानवर को वो जानवर रहने का जगह को विशेष ध्यान से इसको सुरक्षा देते हैं ताकि जानवर उसको पकड़ने नहीं जाते अगर पकड़ेगा तो उसका सजा ऐसा के लिए वाइल्ड सैंक्चुरीज एंड नेशनल पार्क्स द Jimkorbet National Park in Uttarakhand, and Kasirga National Park in Assam are the national parks in northern India. Which are they? The national parks in northern India are Jimkorbet National Park in Uttarakhand, and then Kasirga National Park in Assam. The Sultanpur Bird Sanctuary in Gurgaon, Haryana is famous in this region. Two wildlife sanctuaries and one bird sanctuary. Kasirga National Park in Assam, Jimkorbet National Park in Uttarakhand, and the Sultanpur Bird Sanctuary in Gurgaon, Haryana. These are the three national parks and the wildlife sanctuaries in this northern region. Now you read these lessons very carefully, 5 times, and learn these new words very carefully. Each one word 10 times. After that, you can go to the notes, fill in blanks for false question answer, glossary. Glossary is also you must learn. And now we can read the words in this lesson. We have to learn each and every word thoroughly. Otherwise, when we learn the answers, we have a problem and we cannot write properly in the exam. Okay? So, you have to learn these words very thoroughly. Okay? Now I am going to read these words. You follow. Mountains. Lands. Landforms. Formation. Formation. Climatic. Climatic. Station. Hill station. Himalayas. Himalayas. Approximately. Approximate. Boundary. Boundary. Borders. Borders. Irrigation. Irrigation. Origination. Originating. Consist. Consist. Himadri. Himadri. Himachal. Himachal. Shivalik. Shivalik. Peak. Peak. Glaciers. Glaciers. Located. Located. Slopes. Slopes. Silt. Silt. Aluvium. Aluvium. Fertile. Tributaries. Tributaries. Basin. Basin. Multi. Pur. Poc. Multi-purpose. Gangotri. Gangotri. Confluence. Confluence. Regional. 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 Traditional. IDENTIFYING. Identifying. TRIBE. Tribe. CULTIVAD. Cultivable. SANCTUARIES. Sanctuaries. PRESERVATION. Preservation. This was 10 times read and learn. Okay, thank you.